guys, how's it going? Welcome back to the channel. So I'm going to try something today, just to kind of backtrack a little bit to some of my previous videos where I kind of described how the rock band game works and the tracks that I'm playing along to. So a lot of what I'm playing are custom songs, so just, you know, people are making songs that I might otherwise not be able to play just because they're not officially released songs to the game. So that being said, the way that the official songs worked is most of the time they use master tracks, so the actual instrument tracks were split, which is how the drums are removed in a lot of the tracks that I play along to. But in a lot of cases with the custom songs, they don't have the master tracks, obviously, so it's just using an MP3 file or something like that. So it's literally just, you know, a song that you download and then playing along to it. So it's not really possible to remove the individual instrument tracks. The reason I say that is because I believe that this song is one of them. This is a live version of Turn the Page from Bob Seger. So I'm very, very familiar with this song. I mean, if I'm being honest, I probably heard Metallica's version more thoroughly before I got around to going back to this original version. And they each have their own merits. Obviously, there's nothing quite like the original, and, you know, for a Metallica fan like myself, you definitely have an appreciation for their version as well. So this version is not nearly as hard rocking as Metallica's, as to be expected, so it's a little bit on the lighter side of drums. But I just wanted to kind of set that expectation with the track not being removed at the beginning, because I do feel that if the recording kind of picks up on the actual drum track as much as mine, it can have kind of an echo effect. So I just want to, if it does, I'll see when the recording is done if it did or not, and this might be a kind of a moot point, but I just want to say that going into it, that it is a possibility. So if it's unlistenable, this video probably won't see the light of day, but generally they've all turned out okay. So that being said, I expect it to be a really fun song. I haven't actually tried it, but obviously I've heard it a lot, and I do know that it is a bit on the lighter rhythm side of things. So, you know, I figure it'll be a kind of a fun change. So without any further delay, this is the live version of Turn the Page from Bob Seger.
I know.
So actually, what I mentioned at the beginning of the song, as I said, could turn out to be kind of a moot point, because as I got into the song, I realized that this one actually was a song where the master track was used, and so the whole doubling of the drum track didn't really apply. So I guess never mind. But overall, it's kind of weird how it works sometimes, because as you could tell during that song, it's a much slower rhythm. There was a lot of cymbal work, not a lot of really tough rhythms or anything like that. There was a couple of fills that were quite fun, but overall pretty approachable. But it's funny how that works sometimes. You get in kind of a mindset of, you know, rocking out. Like the last few songs over the last few days that I released, you can tell were a lot harder rocking songs. And so when I'm in a recording session like this one, where I'm doing 4 or 5 songs in a row, and you get kind of in the rhythm of hard rocking, and then you slow it down for a song like this, for me in my brain, I just want to go faster. And so it's almost harder in a way to play a slower song, because I'm kind of fighting my brain. I don't know if that's the normal for any other drummers or musicians out there, but yeah, it can definitely be tougher to slow down when, you know, you kind of have the urge to play faster. Obviously, that defeats the purpose of playing along to a song like this. But overall, super fun song to play. And, you know, it's very, very much slower rhythm, but it's a very iconic song. It's a super fun song. And like I said, it had some really fun fills in it. They weren't super difficult, but they were well-placed and overall very enjoyable. So hope you guys enjoyed it as well. If you did, feel free to like, share, subscribe. I do actually have a version of Metallica's Turn the Page that I can play along to, which I think, now that I go back, might have confused it with this version in terms of which one used the multi-track. So this one, like I said, the drum track was removed, so it's all good. But I believe the Metallica one that I have used the MP3, so that would be the one where there's potential interference between my drums and the official drums. So that might be something I visit in the future, but for now I wanted to get this version out there because it's the original, it's the classic, and you know, this is the one that probably more people are familiar with, especially if you're not really a Metallica fan. So I wanted to get it out there. So again, if you liked, feel free to like, share, subscribe, throw any other requests my way, and otherwise I hope you're having a great day as always, and I will talk to you later. See ya.